Local Memphis Live. Now, here's your host, Amy Spiropoulos. Good morning and welcome to Local Memphis Live. We've got Chef Logan. We've got hot sauce. Is this a joke? No, it's not a joke. It is going to be a great show, though. Thanks for joining us. We have a sense of humor here on Local Memphis Live. We've got big news from one of our favorites in the Mid-South who stood very tall and proud for his hometown of Memphis, Tennessee. We're talking about Chef Logan Guloff. Welcome him this morning.
Oh,
and
thank
you know,
you.
If anybody has watched my show for a minute, they know hot sauce and Chef Logan and live TV.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just something you got to laugh about.
No. Never forget the chicken.
Never forget the hot chicken that choked me up the entire almost hour of the show.
Yep.
But hey, you know what? It's always such a pleasure to have you. And yet another award to add to your ever-long resume.
Yep, I won the World Gourmand Award for the USA. So I have the best first book in the U.S.
Oh,
and
my
I got
gosh.
This fancy little sticker. So look. Yeah,
look
yeah,
at
you
that.
Can.
Look at that. So tell us, what does this mean? If folks at home, that sticker is what he's talking about.
So,
what does that mean, Logan?
That means like World Gourmand Awards. They're basically this massive cookbook award, and they have a whole show in China, and then they have the book fair in Frankfurt, Germany.
Oh my
and
gosh.
And so it's really like worldwide cookbook awards.
That's amazing.
Organization. And they're listed up there with the James Beard Cookbook Awards. So these are big time awards right here.
And how old are you now?
I'm 15.
You are 15. Has a 15-year-old ever gotten this prestigious award?
I don't think so. I don't know. I'll have to check it.
That's amazing.
That is first book. So like this is my very first one, and so I won the award in all the USA.
I mean, when your first book gets an honor like that, where in the world do you go from there?
China.
China. And you are going to be going to China, right?
Oh, hopefully. I don't know.
Hopefully. Our fingers are crossed.
I hope.
He was also just named a
blendetarian.
Yeah.
So what that means, I mix meat with mushrooms.
I love
it. So, like, you see this meat, and I got my Donna hot sauce there. Not too much.
Not too much. That's right.
And then you mix it right in with the mushrooms.
And these are?
Those are just, food processed with parsley.
Oh, my.
So it should be really fragrant, really aromatic.
And this is interesting because blendetarians do better, eat better, win-win. It really incorporates health right at the forefront.
Because mushrooms have like a lot of nutrients.
That's
right. And they got a lot of flavor too.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got like all that umaminess that's pretty hard to get otherwise.
It's wonderful. And you've actually made a dish with this. What is that?
Oh. So right here, I'm cooking my beef kebabs.
Oh my
now, I've got my entire thing of seasoning.
Okay.
Now this one isn't hot.
Okay.
This is the seasoning I use, so that goes in there.
All right.
With the mushrooms, and then the meat goes in.
Okay.
And then the egg.
You mix it all together.
Yeah.
Look at that. And does this just, I mean, it not only brings up the flavor, brings out the flavor, but it also makes it healthier and things
that,
as you were mentioning.
It does a lot of great things because it's really low on fat and cholesterol, but high on flavor.
Yes.
And most importantly, low on salt.
And how important is using green and vegetables? I mean, we've talked about it forever.
Well,
and this is Heart Health Month, so we're trying to incorporate more veggies into our diet.
Yep. Well, you know, parsley's really good. It's got a lot of flavor. And mushrooms are really good because they're, like, delicious and healthy. And, I mean, they're going to save the world.
I believe. Well, and it certainly saved you because you won the James Beard Award with mushrooms.
With mushrooms.
So. I love that.
Yeah.
That is awesome. So you just roll it into, like, a sort of a hot dog style, right?
Just kind of a simple kebab, and then you just kind of roll it. Fell apart on me.
That's okay. That's okay.
You know, you can get two of these.
Yeah.
So you just kind of roll it. Actually, using the silicone one.
So I'm so sorry.
That was a little bit better.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You just kind of roll it, and that's kind of how you flip it.
That looks delicious. It smells delicious.
So it's supposed to flip.
Well, that's okay. No, it is. It is. There we go.
There we go.
Yeah.
And so then you get the delicious griddle taste indoors. And you can really smell the spices.
Honey, it smells delicious. And this is the finished. Now, what is this white over here?
All right, now that is actually like a yogurt tzatziki style sauce there.
Oh, my gosh.
And,
You were feeling the Greek with Spiropoulos, weren't you? See, that's what, look at that. And you've got this.
I've got my, like, chickpea salad, and then I've got the pita bread, the two kebabs, and the, like, tzatziki drizzle.
How healthy is this?
Oh, it's really healthy because only half of that is ground beef.
Oh, my gosh.
So half of it is actually mushrooms.
Wow.
So half of it are mushrooms.
Okay, this is probably a silly question on my part, but when you put it in the blender, I mean, you don't want it.
In the food processor.
I mean, sorry, see?
Why you're the chef, I'm the television talk host. Don't put it in the blender. Put it in the food processor, because that's what texture I was going to ask you.
That's how you get it. I mean, it's really simple. You just put, like, the parsley and the mushroom in the blender.
Okay.
Just pulse it around, and then you get this, and then you add the spices, and then you blend it with your meat.
Wow.
And then you're going to add your egg.
So you use less meat and more mushroom, making it healthier.
Oh, yeah, and you stretch your beef, because you still have half a package of ground beef. So you can go make a whole other ground beef dinner out of this.
That's brilliant. That is brilliant. Yeah. So any type of mushrooms? I know there are a lot of types out there.
You know, they're all really delicious.
Okay.
You can use white mushrooms. You can use portobello mushrooms.
Okay.
You can use shiitake mushrooms. You can use whatever mushrooms you want.
But it just adds to the flavor, the consistency.
It's just,
I love that.
The best.
And, you know, I really want to say a shout-out to Logan again, because if you've not gotten his book, it
is fabulous. And you can actually go
so
get it at Bookstock. I'll be at the library Bookstock.
Oh, awesome.
So for the local authors. And it'll also be at Novel, which is a bookstore locally.
Yes, in East Memphis.
Yeah.
That's
and,
right.
Of course, it's still at Burks. And
I
sell it online and also on Amazon.
So now you will have an award-winning book. I mean, it was a winner to us before, just so you know, Chef Logan. But it's really cool because it's got the foreword from Jessica Biel,
from
who, of course, is JT's, you know.
Yeah.
And were you watching the big game, by the way?
Great game,
man. I was waiting to see a cameo by her, though.
Oh, yeah.
I love it. I have no doubt. And look, with Gordon Ramsay. Oh, my gosh, you look so young.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Oh, wow. But I just love these pictures because the whole cookbook is just so wonderful. And it's so unique because it's almost got, like, the cartoon.
Oh, yeah, it's got the manga anime style. And it's got this whole story. And so I've got all these characters, and I wrote the whole story. And I was like, oh, my God, how do I write a story? And then you kind of go into, like, cooking, and you're like, oh, my gosh, now I'm cooking these recipes from the story.
I love it.
And it's really unique.
I've never seen one like it, honestly.
I mean, it's the best first book that gourmand life in the U.S.
Absolutely. Hey, high five to you, man. That is so awesome. It is fabulous. And, Chef, we're going to have you back because I have no doubt big, big, big things for you.
I'm sure something else is coming up.
I am sure. I got to ask you, is there going to be a second?
Oh, yes. Yes, it's a series.
Oh!
So, yeah, I mean, I'm trying to work on the second book. You know,
I love it.
Maybe the cat might get stolen. There's going to be the ninja.
Okay. You heard it here first, Chef Logan Guloff. Chef, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we're going to cross our fingers that China trip comes to fruition.
Oh, yeah.
So it is
awesome. I
might
win best book in the world.
Oh, my gosh. That's so fabulous.
Here.
Well, just so you know, you've already won from our staff.
All right. Thank
you're
you.
Awesome. Absolutely. Coming up in today's show, we have got a great show for you. First up, you're